Welcome to the Patterns of Inheritance GEM, produced by the Division of Genomic Medicine at UC Davis. This video will walk you through the basic laws of inheritance, or how traits are passed on in a family. A person has two copies of most genes, one copy from their mom, and one copy from their dad. Understanding how changes in genes can affect a patient is an important part of clinical diagnostics. Diseases caused by mutations in a single gene are usually inherited in a simple pattern, depending on a few factors, such as location of the gene. Most single gene disorders are rare, but all combined, single gene disorders affect millions of people in the United States. In fact, about 1 in 10 Americans are affected by a rare disease. There are several basic modes of inheritance that exist for single gene disorders. They are autosomal dominant, autosomal recessive, X-linked, and mitochondrial. Let's talk about these one by one. If the condition associated with the gene is observed when an individual has only one copy of a mutation in the gene, then the allele is dominant. An autosomal gene refers to a gene on any of the chromosomes 1 through 22, the autosomes, not on either of the sex chromosomes. Autosomal dominant conditions are often seen in every generation of a family history, as shown in the pedigree here. Conditions that follow an autosomal dominant pattern of inheritance include Huntington's chorea, Marfan's, achondroplasia, and familial hypercholesterolemia. If a person must inherit two copies of a particular variant of a gene in order for the associated condition to appear, the trait is said to be recessive. As the name would suggest, an autosomal recessive condition is a condition that follows a recessive pattern of inheritance and is associated with a gene on an autosome. Autosomal recessive conditions are usually not seen in every generation of a family history, as shown in the pedigree here. Conditions that follow an autosomal recessive pattern of inheritance include Tay-Sachs disease, sickle cell anemia, cystic fibrosis, and PKU. As the name implies, X-linked conditions are conditions associated with genes on the X chromosome. X-linked conditions disproportionately affect males. This is because males have one X chromosome and one Y chromosome, so males are hemizygous for genes on the X chromosome. A female often needs to inherit two copies of the mutation in order for the condition to be expressed. However, this is not always the case. Note that fathers cannot pass any X-linked traits to their sons. Conditions that follow an X-linked pattern of inheritance include Fragile X, hemophilia A, Fabry disease, and Duchenne muscular dystrophy. Another type of inheritance pattern that you might encounter on the job is mitochondrial inheritance. Mitochondrial DNA is only passed through the maternal line. A newly formed embryo receives all of its mitochondria from the mother through the egg cell, so mothers pass their mitochondrial DNA to all of her children. Men never pass any mitochondrial information to any of their children. Note that mitochondrial conditions can affect both males and females, but can only be passed on by females. Conditions that follow a mitochondrial inheritance pattern include Leber's hereditary optic neuropathy and Kearns-Sayre syndrome. It is important to keep in mind, however, that not all genetic conditions follow one of these four patterns, and for some conditions, family members with the same mutation may not have the same symptoms. Furthermore, sometimes individuals with different mutations can have the same or similar characteristics. This is in part because gene expression is influenced by both genes and the environment. To recap, there are four main patterns of inheritance for single gene conditions. Of course, many common medical problems do not have a single genetic cause. Rather, they come about as a result of the effects of multiple genes in combination with lifestyle and environmental factors. Traits which come about as a result of the effect of multiple genes or gene-environment interactions are known as complex or multifactorial disorders. Although complex disorders often run in families, they do not have a clear pattern of inheritance, so it can be difficult to determine a person's risk of inheritance. Conditions that are complex or multifactorial include heart disease, diabetes, and obesity. Knowing your patient's family history, combined with an understanding of genetic inheritance patterns, is an invaluable tool for clinical diagnostics. This video covered some of the most common inheritance patterns for single gene conditions, as well as mitochondrial disorders. However, many health conditions are complex or multifactorial and do not follow one of these four patterns. If you would like help working through a patient's family history to determine whether risk of inheritance can be predicted or to calculate probability of disease inheritance, the Division of Genomic Medicine is here to help. Our clinic is located in the Mind Institute on the medical campus in Sacramento. You can refer patients to our genomic medicine clinic, visit our website, or call us with questions or to speak with a genetic counselor.